happy Sunday morning to all listeners. I'm going to speak for the next 5 to 10 minutes about thyroid issues and subfertility. So for those couples who are facing with faced with fertility issues, you would all be aware that most of you will undergo a thyroid function test. So thyroid is an organ which affects the entire body. It affects our metabolism, the way we think, our nervous system, and there's no surprise that it also affects our ability to conceive also. It affects both male and female fertility. So I'll come briefly about some of the features, how it affects fertility and how you can improve your thyroid function and thereby correct fertility issues. So when it comes to thyroid gland, there are two different dysfunctions that are possible. One is that the thyroid gland is underactive, which is called hypothyroidism. In hypothyroidism, you have these hormones T4 and T3, which are slightly low, and TSH, which is elevated. And in hypothyroidism, especially if women have hypothyroidism, if it is overt hypothyroidism, that is the TSH is greater than 10, and you can have various reasons for the woman not being able to conceive. The most important among them is that the TSH can increase the prolactin. So many a times you may have an evaluation where prolactin is done, but the thyroid function is not being performed. So in such cases, performing a thyroid function will really help you in simply treating this condition. And also it may be associated with anovulation, prolonged hypothyroidism, hypothyroidism or TSH, which is more than 10 or 15, which has not been corrected for months together, will prevent ovulation from happening. That means the egg, which has to release every month once, will not get released, and that can result in subfertility among women. So, how successful is treatment of overt hypothyroidism? I would say in my clinical practice, in the last, say, maybe about 8 years of practice, I've had universal success whenever I've treated women who had overt hypothyroidism as a cause of subfertility. So that is, the couple had a difficulty conceiving. They tried to conceive after having corrected the thyroid function, and then we found out that they were able to conceive without any difficulty within 1 or 2 months. Actually, in fact, the conception happened so quickly within the first 1 or 2 months itself that we need to be careful. In fact, I have to tell patients that you check your thyroid function test, make it normal before you conceive, because what happens is that if you conceive while the thyroid function is being corrected, your TSH can still stay above 2.5 actually, which can lead on to miscarriage. Okay, I'll come to the topic of miscarriage a little later in my elaboration today. But typically, treatment of hypothyroidism helps women conceive if they have a TSH well above 10. So the gray zone is TSH in the range of say 2.5 and 10, whether it really helps or not. But since thyroid hormone supplementation does not have any side effects and it does not cause any adverse effect on fertility per se, treatment of mild hypothyroidism is also favored by many fertility specialists, though there are not many research regarding this actually. But any value of about 10 and 15 definitely requires treatment. 2.5 to 10, we do offer treatment to most subjects after performing a thyroid antibody test called anti-TPU. This is our routine approach in women who have fertility issues and not able to conceive. So, if you do have thyroid dysfunction, do consult your endocrinologist, who is best qualified to actually evaluate you and treat you for thyroid dysfunction. And at Magna Centers, we have a clinic in at Bangalore, Chennai and Hyderabad. And remember to, get in touch with us via this Facebook, or you can look us up at magnacode.co.in, and then you can get in touch with us. And coming to hyperthyroidism, hyperthyroidism is a condition wherein the thyroid gland is overactive. It is spewing out lot of hormone, and in hyperthyroidism you get T3, T4 both, which are elevated, and a TSH which is suppressed. So typically hyperthyroidism is very symptomatic, with the patient losing weight, having lot of sweating, palpitations, abnormal unawareness of heart rate, all these things. And along with that, there may be a difficulty in conceiving also. Sometimes the hyperthyroidism is very mild and missed. The symptoms are not that very prominent, and during the course of trying to conceive, the woman comes to know that there is hyperthyroidism. Treatment of hyperthyroidism also restores fertility. Hyperthyroidism, by making the body weak, prevents conception. And also there can be frequent menses or polymenorrhea and heavy menstrual bleeding. Again, an ovulation can occur with hyperthyroidism. An ovulation means the inability to release egg every month. So this is a very common this thing. It is not that only women are affected by thyroid disorders when it comes to pregnancy. Men are also equally affected. So in overt hypothyroidism, if it is not treated, it causes erectile dysfunction or delayed or absent ejaculation among women, among men actually. And this can affect fertility chances. It reduces the libido and reduces the frequency of sexual intercourse among men. So this again can be a cause for hypothyroidism among men. So if there is uncontrolled hypothyroidism, the sperm quality also can get affected. And treatment of hypothyroidism in men also improves fertility. So because of this, thyroid function is something that is routinely performed in all fertility evaluations. So if you really are having fertility issues and you have not had a thyroid function test or an evaluation by an endocrinologist, do get in touch with us, via magnacode.co.in. And coming to the issue of miscarriages. Miscarriage is again a very common problem that we find with in association with thyroid disorders. Hyperthyroidism causes repeated fetal loss if the hyperthyroidism is not properly treated, and very often it is mismanaged, and the proper treatment is not given, because of which there is fetal loss actually. So whenever you find suppressed TSH or a low TSH and T3, T4 high, it indicates hyperthyroidism. And hyperthyroidism can be associated with fetal loss or, first trimester miscarriage, abortions in the first few weeks of life, for first few weeks of pregnancy. So coming to hypothyroidism, hypothyroidism is commonly associated with something called autoimmune thyroid disease. So we diagnosed autoimmune thyroid disease using two or three different mechanisms. One way is doing a blood test. We do a thyroid antibody. We can also diagnose by using an ultrasound of the neck. We can do an ultrasound and see how the thyroid gland looks. And if the thyroid gland looks very dark, hypoechogenic, we make a diagnosis of autoimmunity. And thyroid autoimmunity has been associated with a twofold higher risk of miscarriage among women. So treating women with thyroid autoimmunity, even though their thyroid function is normal, like for example, you might have performed a thyroid function test which is normal, you may be feeling fairly all right. But then when you go with an antithyroid antibody test and you have found out that the antibody is positive, treating with the thyroid drug will really help in conceiving actually. So this is something that needs to be looked into actually. And performing an antibody test in women who have had one miscarriage has been recommended by American Thyroid Association also. So in order to see whether that is a cause of miscarriage, and if the anti-TPO is positive, we can address it by giving a thyroid thyroid supplementation and following up the thyroid function regularly during pregnancy. So with this, I would like to summarize in brief about thyroid dysfunction and fertility. One is treatment of overt hypothyroidism or frank hypothyroidism and hyperthyroidism definitely has a benefit in women who have subfertility. So if you have difficulty in conceiving, do get your thyroid function test done and meet up with your endocrinologist to make sure that your thyroid function test is normal. Secondly, even men can be affected by hyperthyroidism or hypothyroidism, mainly by way of sexual dysfunction. And treatment of this disorder will help in better male sexual performance, and infertility, which is attributed to this, can improve. And sometimes in severe hypothyroidism cases, that improves. And also when it comes to recurrent miscarriage, proper management of the thyroid function, including evaluation of thyroid antibody, will help in better management of your thyroid disorder. So with these, I would like to conclude my small update today. And do stay in touch with us and like us on Facebook, and do share this video with your friends. so that you know they are able to also benefit from the health messages that Magna Center keeps bringing out for you. Thank you for listening to me on a Sunday morning, and hope this has benefited you and your friends. Thank you.